In this video, I will talk about Ohm's law, its implications in a circuit, and in the last portion, I will talk about the polarity of a resistor. Voltage V, current I, and the resistance R. These three are the most fundamental parameters in an electric circuit. The law that establishes the relationship between these three, voltage, current, and resistor, is known as Ohm's law. This relationship was first discovered by German scientist George Simon Ohm. Therefore, this law is named after George Simon Ohm and it is called Ohm's law. So, what is the statement of this Ohm's law? The current I through a conductor is directly proportional to the voltage difference across it, provided the physical conditions do not change. Physical conditions are the parameters that influence the resistivity of a circuit, such as length, area, temperature, and material type. So let me concentrate on the first portion. The current I through a conductor is directly proportional to the voltage difference across it. Let's say I have a resistor here. The value of the resistor is R. Let's say this is A terminal and this is B terminal. With respect to this AB terminal, I have applied a constant voltage, let's say V. This terminal is at higher potential and this terminal is at lower potential. As a result, I will get a current flow through this resistor. Now, Ohm's law states that the current through this resistor R will be directly proportional to the voltage difference across this A and B terminal, which I can write like this, V proportional to I. As we have a proportional sign here, to take out this proportional sign, I have to put a constant here. Therefore, I will take R into I. This R is a constant and it implies the value of a resistance or resistor. Okay, now the current depends on the voltage. That means this voltage is the independent parameter, and as the current depends on voltage, it will be dependent parameter. Now, if I want to draw the voltage and current relationship, I will take V in the x-axis and I in the, or the dependent variable in the y-axis. See, as this is a linear relation, I will get a straight line like this. Now, if I rearrange this equation, I will get an equation like this. I will be equal to 1 by R into V. This is our independent variable. This is our dependent variable. Now see, if I compare this equation with the equation of a straight line which is going through the origin, I will get an equation like this. Y equal to mx. Here, y will represent our dependent variable I. X will represent our independent variable voltage. Therefore, our M will be equal to 1 by R. That means slope of this IV curve will be equal to 1 by R. And how do we calculate 1 by R from this straight line? Let's say I take a voltage V1. At that instant, our current is equal to I1. Let's say I take another voltage of V2. At that instant, our current is I2. Now, I can calculate 1 by R, which is the slope of this straight line, equal to Y2 minus Y1. That means I2 minus I1 divided by V2 minus V1. Therefore, I can calculate our resistor R equal to V2 minus V1 divided by I2 minus I1, from which I can write our resistance will be equal to ratio of change of voltage divided by change of current. That means if I want to calculate the resistance from an IV curve, I will take the ratio of change in voltage to change in current. Okay. There are three widely used method of writing Ohm's law. First one is V equal to I R. Second one is that if I want to calculate current from Ohm's law, I have to take I equal to V divided by R. Or if I want to calculate the resistance R, I will take the ratio of voltage and current. See, I can express that using a triangle like this, and this is known as ohmic triangle. If I want to calculate voltage, I will take the multiplication of current into resistor. If I want to calculate current, I will take the ratio of voltage and resistor. Or if I want to calculate resistor, I will take the ratio of voltage and current. Now from this relationship, I can deduce V is directly proportional to I. That means our current will increase proportionally with the increase in voltage. Second one is, from the second one I can deduce this relationship, I will be directly proportional to the inverse of resistor if this V is constant. Here I have considered this resistance R will be constant. Here you will see in this relation, if the value of resistor increases, the current in this equation will decrease. Third one implies that in a linear circuit, if the value of voltage increases, our current increases proportionally. Therefore, the ratio of V and I will always be constant. Now, let's say if I keep this resistance R constant, therefore I will get the relationship between the voltage and current will be a proportional relationship. That means if I increase the potential difference across these two terminals, I will get an increment in the current proportional to the applied voltage. Let's say I have a wire here. I have connected the two ends of this battery with the wire, and the resistance of this wire equal to 70 ohm. Now I keep the voltage at 1.5 volt. At that instant, our current is 21.4 milliampere. Now let's say I have increased the voltage by an amount of 0.5 volt. You'll see now our current will be equal to 28.6. That means with an increment of voltage of 0.5 volt, I am getting a current increment around 7.2 milliampere. Now let's say if I further increase the voltage by an amount of another 0.5 volt, you will see now our current will be equal to 35.7. That means I will get a current increment of around 7.1 milliampere. Let's say I have increased the voltage by an amount of another 0.5 volt. You will see our current will be equal to 42.9 milliampere. Therefore, I will get a current increment of 7.2 milliampere. That means if I increase the value of voltage by an amount of 0.5 volt, our current will increase by an amount of around 7.2 milliampere. This is a linear relationship. That means our current will change proportionally with respect to the applied voltage. Now, let me show you the second relationship. Here, if I keep the voltage V constant, therefore our current and voltage will change like this. It will be an inversely proportional. That means if I increase the amount of resistance, our current will decrease. See here, if I keep this voltage constant at 3.0 volt, now if I increase the amount of resistance in the circuit, you will see our current will decrease. Therefore it will get thinner. See, if our resistance is 100 ohm, our current is only 30 milliampere. Now if I increase it further, let's say our current is only 20.3 milliampere. Now if I increase the resistance further, let's say at 202 ohm, our current is only 14.9 milliampere. See, as the value of resistance increased, our current gets decreased. See, for a resistance of 506 ohm, our current is only 5.9 milliampere. Now I will talk about the polarity of a resistor. Polarity, that means the positive and negative side of a resistor. Let's say I have a resistor R here. Usually a resistor is a non-polar element, but depending upon the direction of current, it will attain positive and negative side. Let's say this is a resistor R and this is a resistor R. This is C terminal, this is D terminal. with respect to this C and D terminal, I have applied a voltage difference V, okay, and let's say this terminal is at higher potential and this terminal is at lower potential. Therefore, our current will flow from higher to lower potential as current is entering from this direction. Therefore, this side will be positive, and as the current will be leaving from this direction in the resistor, therefore this terminal will be negative. Or let's say if this terminal is at higher potential and this terminal is at lower potential, our current will be entering from this direction and leaving this resistor in this direction. Therefore, this terminal will be positive and this terminal will be negative. Simply, the direction from which the current is entering to the resistor, that side will be positive, and the direction in which the current leaving, that side will be negative. This is the polarity of a resistor.